Hey, this video is for Santa Barbara. This is going to be for unit number 206, which is going to be a men's, BYU approved men's unit here. Santa Barbara, great location. We're sitting here on roughly about 550 north, I believe. Oh, here's the sign right here. So 560 north and 790 east. So basically, right where that motorcycle just went by, that's 700 east. If you were to go about two blocks up, you'd start entering into the bottom of BYU campus. So very easy walking distance from campus. If I were to go up this road here, about another block and a half, it would put me right on Condo Row, if you're familiar with where that is, which is also very close to campus. So building itself, brick, stucco, very low maintenance exterior. In fact, even on this one, and this one has, and I'll try to get around here so you can see, it has a bar tile roof on it, which normally they're just going to be the three tab shingles on that, but you can see that's going to be a, you know, should be a lifetime roof there. So anyway, Santa Barbara is going to have three buildings. There's a good mix of both boys units and girls units in here. The way that BYU does it is every entrance can be a different gender, so you can have you know, the boys and the girls, and you know, vice versa, kind of next to each other that way. So you can have two assigned parking stalls. So for 206, it'll be right where the silver car is here. It's gonna be one of them. There's gonna be some visitor stalls like this one. It looks like there's another one right there. And then also you can have one assigned covered stall, which would be right where this gold car is unit number 206. So two and a few, which is gonna be typical for next to campus. But seems to work just great. And then of course you got street parking out here in front. So you'll notice on these ones here that all the staircases going into the units are all indoors. So the advantage there is you're not gonna have to deal with any icing on the steps or you know, cold weather that direction. Even though there are exterior doors on the inside, it provides that level of weather protection that way. So right here you can see that on the second and third floor, we're gonna have that bay window. Kind of pops you out, gives you a little more square footage than the ground floor. Also kind of gets you off the main level, so it gives you privacy that direction. So each of these stairwells will basically have six units in it. So we're up here on the second floor. So we turn right here. There's gonna be unit number 206. You can see the HOA, put a little cork board, very smart. Kind of help with the advertising. You can imagine how the students get bombarded with advertising on their condos, and then they don't have to stick it to the door. So right there is gonna be your entry. There's a shot of your living room, and you can see the paint's been two-toned. So right up above, you can see the crown molding. Looks like about a 3-inch crown. It's just popping out. It's got a, looks nice that way with the two-tone. That's the advantage of doing the two-tone. The ceiling fan right here, great touch for the living room. You've got big old leather sofa there, leather chair. The love sack is what they call them, the beanbag chair. That would, of course, be the students. So there's gonna be your living room, dining area. So this is that bay window that we saw on the outside. So it makes the dining area great because it just pops out that extra little room there in the kitchen. And there's gonna be a shot of the fridge. You'll notice the cabinets are going clear to the ceiling. You have extra storage that direction. Dishwasher. And then right there is gonna be the oven range. So this one's gonna have a gas oven range. Santa Barbara was actually plumbed for both gas and electric. It's very rare to see gas inside a student condo on it, because electric is pretty cheap, but of course gas is much nicer to cook on. So right over here, as you're going down to the bedroom areas, you're gonna have, this is gonna be the bathroom here. You see the marble lights around, tub and shower. There's a shot of the vinyl, similar to what we saw in the kitchen. And then the vanity mirror and light there. Going on down here to the end of the hall, Santa Barbara is one of the few
that will have its own laundry room. Usually these are just put inside of a closet or whatnot, but this one actually can be closed off. You've got the side-by-side washer, and again, cabinets that will go all the way to a ceiling, the ceiling there, to give extra storage. This little linen closet here, you know, of course students don't have linen, so it just becomes more storage for them, which of course you can't get enough of the storage. And then right here is going to be our furnace and water heater. Gas furnace, gas water heater, and central air are all standard on the Santa Barbara condominiums. And then these are also have been wired up for the Google Fiber as well. So this is going to be the shared room. So Santa Barbara was zoned for three people, so you're going to have one shared room and one private room. They've gone not only with the captain's beds in here, as you can see right here, gives you that extra space and a dresser underneath your bed, but they've also got an upright dresser in here as well. So it's kind of gives you overkill on the on storage, which again, can't have too much, right? So right here is going to be the closet with the double shelves right there, and then they've got a desk with the hutch right there. These rooms are also two-tone, as you can see how it pops off and makes that molding look nice. So this is going to be our private room here, also done with the captain's bed with the dresser underneath, and there is the desk, window with the 2-inch blinds. As I flip around this direction, nice size closet, especially for one guy. So that would be the Santa Barbara, and this is unit number 206.